Gokhan.
Jai Sachidana.
Yes, Jai Sachidana.
So every day, I'm asking myself, what is happiness? Every day, is happiness my work? Is happiness my relationship? Is happiness my child? And I'm asking myself, what is real happiness?
See, happiness is a result of right understanding. By wrong understanding, you will feel unhappiness. By right understanding, you will feel happiness. So happiness is a result. But it is a result of what? Right understanding. Your understanding is wrong, then you feel unhappiness. Only, so happiness or unhappiness is not directly you will get, by it is a result. If you have wrong belief, then you feel happiness, unhappiness, both the things, means maximum unhappiness only. So real happiness means it never ends. There is no unhappiness after happiness. It is called permanent happiness. And that will come after right understanding, right belief. You understood?
Yeah.
So do I understand then that happiness is nothing that you can touch, untouchable? It's like something from the relative world?
No, you cannot touch, but you can experience. You can experience, but by what? By right knowledge, you can experience happiness. Wrong knowledge, you will feel unhappiness. You will experience unhappiness. It is a result. When you are in the stage of pure soul, you are knower and seer, then you will feel bliss within automatically, because soul is having infinite bliss, full of happiness. Soul is nothing but full of happiness, full of knowledge, full of vision, infinite energy, full, so many property of soul. But due to wrong belief, we are separated from soul and we feel that I am Gokhan, and that is a wrong belief, and that will give you unhappiness, effect of body, positive or negative, happiness or unhappiness, but it is relative happiness. When you realize who am I am pure soul, that will give you permanent happiness. You understood?
Yes, I do understand. But it's like the soul is in me, but it feels like you always talk about is as a separation, like a coexistence.
Yeah. See, you are really Gokhan, or your name is Gokhan. What you will say?
In this inversion, I'm Gokhan.
Yeah. So now, you say my name is Gokhan, then you say I am Gokhan. Is there any contradiction between two sentences? If you say this is my house, then you say I am house. Is there any contradiction?
Yeah.
So belonging and honor must be separate. Belongings, my, wherever you apply my house, my wife, my business, my money, my car, my body, my thoughts, mind, everything comes in my department, and you are separate from all these belongings. So belongings totally separate from you. Due to wrong belief, you are owner of these all belongings. And here in Jnan Vidhi, you will get self-realization. What is your part and what is your, what are your real belongings and what are all these relative belongings? You are separated from all these relative things, and you can realize your real thing. Oh, I am pure soul. And that will, once you realize you are pure soul, that will start your real happiness. And this all this relative thing is temporary. When you achieve that thing, you will get happiness, and that is temporary, it will destroy. Your happiness also destroys. This because it is relative. And soul is permanent. Once you get happiness from soul, it will ever last. It never destroys, never finish. It's permanent happiness. You understood?
Yes.
Now third question.
So I have difficulties to see the pure soul. It's like I'm trying. I'm trying it from different from the worldly aspects, but I have difficulties to see the soul, the pure soul.
Have you taken Gnan?
No.
No. So today you will get that knowledge of self-realization. Then it will be easy to see relative part as well as real part of pure soul. That is, okay. You can understand properly after Gnan Vidhi, Gnan ceremony. You understood?
Yes.
Okay. More question?
No question more.
No, you have mentioned, is there any life after death? Your question?
Yeah.
Yeah, after death, there is, see, physical body changes and soul will take new birth. So after death, there is a life. Again new birth and whole life we have to spend. Again death, again new life. Once you realize pure soul, then he will be come out from cycle of life and death. He will experience permanency. Because life and death is of phases of soul, not absolute pure soul. Understood?
Okay, I'm understood. Thank you.
Suzina.
Jai Sat Chit Anand.
Jai Sat Chit Anand.
I read in one of these books of you, you say we have to overcome sexuality.
Yeah.
Can you explain why? Because for me it's a natural power and energy. Is it not the addiction that is causing the problem?
No. We have to understand we have to keep normality. Above normal is poison. Keep normality. So if it is a normality, then it is normal. Whatever you say, it is giving energy or whatever. And one more thing, sexuality requires body or it requires to soul?
Both.
Both? Not at all. The soul is full of happiness, full of bliss, infinite bliss. So who doesn't have happiness, he requires, I want some happiness through body, through sexuality. But soul is full of happiness. It doesn't require at all. So body and egoism, honor of this body, they require sexuality. They want companion. They want security. That's why it is needed in worldly life. One who is separated from this body, ego, intellect, and when he get experience of pure soul, he doesn't require. You understood?
Yes, I understand.
So both the things, body required food, but soul doesn't require food because soul is immortal, eternal. And body required, so it required food also, it required security also, it required companion also, it required sexuality also. Everything required to body and honor of the body is egoism. I am Suzine. That required relative things. Soul is not required relative things. You understood?
Yes, it's clear. Thank you.
Jai Sachida. Hariyata.
Would you agree that this energy, the stream of awareness or gnan that you, I don't know, might be able to channel in a way, has a source that is common to all. To all traditions.
See, a source of knowledge or ignorance is really pure soul. So every enlightened person, he realizes his own pure soul. And once he realizes his own soul, he can transfer energy or right knowledge to other people. Without experience of pure soul, man or any person cannot transfer knowledge to other. He will read some literature and transfer to other people. That will not give experience of pure soul. Experienced person can only, by grace of that experienced person, you can also experience your own pure soul. You understood?
And does that transmission require language?
No, really, not required.
Okay.
It was beyond intellect, beyond ego, beyond word. It's a grace, grace of Dada Bhagwan, inner pure soul.
Thank you.
You've also asked another question, that what is the thing that does not allow us to have doubt and what allows us to experience the soul? All these doubts are developed by the intellect, and that is what obstructs the experience of the soul.
You understood? Peter.
I have two questions, and one was almost answered, but I want to come back to that. It's about sexuality. Does it mean when Peter has sex that it's okay unless the pure soul is not attached to it?
Yeah, it is file. We have to solve with equanimity. It is a Peter is doing and you are knower and seer. So whatever Peter is doing, it is a discharge of past karma. In Akram Vignan, in this spiritual science, this sexual relation with wife, if you are understanding that I am pure soul and this is my file, I have to solve with equanimity, then you are not going to charge new karma. But you have to keep awareness that file one is doing this sexual relation and I am pure soul. You understood?
Could you elaborate a little bit on that? Does it mean that while I'm doing, while I'm in sexual interaction, I have to be in awareness of pure soul? Is that what you mean? Could you elaborate on that, please?
You have to understand that what you have eaten, that is what is going to get discharged. In other words, what you have charged is what is going to be discharged. What you have planned in
project,
your past life,
project in past life,
your past life's project, according to that, your discharge karma will occur in this life. For example, if I have not charged or had any such project of sexuality in my past life, then that kind of discharge of sexuality is not coming forth or showing up in this life for me. Now you can change your next life's project or plan according to your intent in this life. But whatever plan or project was already done in the past life, that you have to experience in this life.
You have to finish in this life with equanimity.
Did you understand?
So partially I understand, but not really clear. So my opinion on it, as I understood you, is like you label it as negative, And I do not feel that's negative. I feel I do not have much attachment, but I do feel it's very okay.
I will ask you one question. With this body, we can get ultimate salvation? Or with this wife, we will get ultimate salvation? Or only with your soul, we will get ultimate salvation? Only with your soul you can get ultimate salvation. All these relative things we have to leave over here. You cannot go in salvation with relative things, material things. So we have to finish over here.
So now I come to my second question. It's more spiritual nature. It's more spiritual question. How do you define pure soul? Is there an I experiencing pure soul, or is there no I anymore experience being soul without an I?
You yourself are experiencing the pure soul.
Due to wrong belief, due to ignorance of pure soul, you are believing that I am Peter. That's why you are separated. You feel that I am separated from my soul and you feel oneness with Peter.
And then you feel an I? That means there is somebody there?
No, existence is there. Our own existence is there. But we are...
We have the awareness that we exist. I have the awareness that I exist. But I do not have the understanding and clarity of what am I? Who am I exactly? But there is already the awareness of existence. Because of wrong belief, we are believing that I am Peter and I am Peter only. This is me only, Peter. And once that wrong belief is dissolved, then one already exists as a pure soul, and that accurate belief then sets in that really I am pure soul.
Okay.
I just got a third question.
Did you understand the answer to the second question?
Intuitively, I did understand, but not really in my intellect.
I will give you one example. One person.
If a person is intoxicated with a lot of alcohol, he may say that I am the president of Germany. But when the intoxication wears down, and goes away, then he will realize again that I am actually Peter only.
So you are really Peter, but due to alcoholic effect, you say, I am president of Germany. I will not allow all of you. You get out from here, something, something. But when your intoxication gets down, you come again, oh, I am Peter. I have to take my food. I have to go to my home. Where is my car? Where is my key? So this wrong belief is just nothing but effect of alcohol. Like other element, just matter, due to matter and pure soul, when they comes in contact, this wrong belief gets generated.
And this is a very personal question to you. Are you also experiencing suffering and happiness, or are you always in constant permanent bliss?
Deepak has the experience of happiness and unhappiness, and I am always experiencing bliss at all times, at every moment.
Both the things are separate.
Okay, danke. Danke schön.
Jai Sachidana.
Danke schön.
Jai Sachidana.
How can I, Claudia, the one who I am really not, feel the pure soul more?
Have you taken Gnan?
Yeah.
You are practicing five principles? Where is Claudia? Yeah. You are practicing five principles?
Sometimes, but really not regularly.
You're reading the Charanvidhi?
Not now.
You can see fault of Claudia? Asking Claudia to do pratikaman? You're seeing fault of Claudia?
Yeah.
So that is a separation, that is the experience of pure soul. One cannot see your own fault. So you are separated from Claudia and you are seeing fault of Claudia. And ask Claudia to do pratikaman. So you are separated from Claudia. So this is beginning of separation and this is beginning of experience of pure soul. And you want more experience of pure soul, then you have to watch what the mind of Claudia is thinking, what the speech is Claudia is coming, what the action of Claudia is doing. So you have to watch thoughts, speech, action, intellect, ego, everything you have to watch. Then watching you are separated from Claudia and you will get more experience of pure soul. Once you watch file one, Claudia, what Claudia is doing, you are knower and seer, that experience is of pure soul experience. You understood?
Yeah, thank you.
So initially now, that two stage of experience. First we have to see fault of Claudia and other flawless vision. So beginning from here, and that will increase when you see Claudia's thoughts, intellect, ego, everything, then you will get more experience of pure soul. You understood?
Thank you.
Jai Sachidananda. Ralph.
Could you elaborate a little bit about the Lords? Who is Lord Rushabdev? Who is Lord Mahavir? Lord Simanda? Lord Krishna? Lord Krish? So is there a kind of hierarchy under those Lords? Is there a Lord government? Where are they? Where is their reign? Can you elaborate on that? What about those Lords?
Lord Rushabdev, Lord Simandar, Lord Mahavir, they achieve full stage. And Lord Krishna, in next life, he will reach to that full stage. So at that time, all are the same place. Absolute stage of pure soul. So they are same, absolute stage of pure soul. Identity are separate. Soul are separate. But quality of the soul is same. They achieve that stage, full stage of absolute pure soul. And they are the one of the evidence for mankind salvation, the biggest evidence for them. They are spreading knowledge of spiritual knowledge and they will help to reach salvation. So by real viewpoint they are same. Full stage, absolute stage. Relatively, physical body is separated. Height, their merit karma got total separate because individual they are separate. You understood?
Yes, I do understand, but I would like to understand, is there a hierarchy?
For whom? Which?
In the Lords, is there anyone?
No hierarchy, above? No hierarchy. Hierarchy means they got self-realization and they reached to full stage. After full stage, there is no hierarchy. When initial stage, in three mantra we are saying Sadhu Bhagavant, Upadhyay Bhagavant, Aryant, Acharya, these are the hierarchy. And see, they are the hierarchy, but after achieving Keval Jnana, absolute stage, then there is no difference. They all are same. If Tri Mantra ni baat kar.
In the Tri Mantra, we are saying salutations and bowings to five different categories of people. One is all the completely enlightened, absolutely enlightened souls, which is called Namo Arihantanam. And then we are saying our bowings to the people who have completely achieved Nirvana, that is Namo Siddhanam. And then the other three are parts of a hierarchy. Namo Ayariyanam are the principles or the leaders of large groups of monks, the principles, that is called Namo Ayariyanam. And Namo Uvazayanam is my bowings to all the teachers of the monks and all the sadhus and all the spiritual seekers. They are teaching, they are the having the position of a teacher, that is called Upadhyay. And the last part of the hierarchy is Namo Loe Sauva Sahunam, where all the monks, all the people who are self-realized, they are indirectly called monks only, all the people who are self-realized, to them we are bowing down. So that is the hierarchy. In that Tri Mantra, the hierarchy is there. Now when we say Namo Arihantanam, all those who have achieved absolute enlightenment and are still in their body right now, they are all equal to each other. Namo Arihantanam, when we say that, all the current present Tirthankars who are there in their body are all equal. For example, Lord Simandar Swami. But when the Tirthankars leave their body also and they achieve a state of absolute enlightenment where there is no body also eventually, that is the state of Nirvana, then we are bowing them in the words that are coming next in the mantra, which is Namo Siddhanam. So for example, Lord Rishabhdev and Lord Mahavir are now considered in the category of Namo Siddhanam, and Lord Simandar Swami is considered in the category of Namo Arihantanam, which is enlightened, absolutely enlightened souls, but with a body present in the universe right now, walking, talking, just like us.
You understood?
It's a little bit complex.
But we have the Tri Mantra. We are praying. You understand? If you understand, then you will get this understanding of all this Rishabhdev Bhagwan, Simandar Swami, everything. Is there any question, another?
Okay, thank you, sir.
You have one more question about universe.
Yeah. And the second question is related a little bit to the first one. Are there other universes as well? And are those universes in the relative or in the real?
See, universe is only one.
And there are six eternal elements in the universe. And because these six elements are eternal, the universe is also eternal. Now in this universe, it's a permanent universe, and these elements are also eternal elements. Now in this universe, there are different areas, like the middle area of the universe is the Madhya Lok, or where there is human lives. Then there is heaven area above, and also there is a hell area as well, in another area in this universe.
You understood?
Yeah.
Okay.